That's awesome. That's really cool.
So I also know that the single-player campaign is a big deal for you guys. You guys were kind enough to answer some questions from PlayStation readers just a week or two back, right before E3. Yeah. Got a little more out of you about exactly, you know, what's happening on the story front. But just tell me about the setup. Tell me about our protagonist, Red Daniels.
Well, you know, Red is like, you know, hundreds of thousands of guys back then enlisted in the war. And, you know, wanted to make a difference. Having no idea what was going on, right? And the first tour of duty is on Normandy and D-Day. And that was, a big thing for a lot of people. So you're experiencing a squadron that is in the, or a platoon that is in the 1st Division that goes across, it starts in Normandy, goes all the way across France, Belgium, and into Germany. It's and some of the biggest battles of World War II, from Battle of the Bulge to Hurricane Forest and the liberation of Paris.
Now, I know you guys are focusing on that European front for the campaign, but I think I caught a hint that maybe it might expand a bit on the multiplayer side. So what are you at liberty to say at this point in time?
Well, we showed a lot in the trailer. You're catching part of it here. This is the Ardennes Forest, which extends from Belgium to Germany. We will take you around Europe, to the border of Russia, to the tip of Africa in Gibraltar.
Cool.
Excellent.
Unique locations to multiplayer, as well as some of the most iconic ones from the campaign. And of course, in the war mode, we have custom-built maps for that mode as well.
Yeah, let's talk about that war mode, because this is something I've been real curious about.
Yeah. Yeah, war is exciting for us. I mean, multiplayer in Call of Duty, we love it. We have the most fun ever with it. But